Hello and welcome to the Ibis Lightning Talk series. My name is Hussain Sultan, and I'm here today to talk to you about Ibis and Substrait and how they're driving standardization in analytics. So let's talk about at a high level on how Ibis supports SQL backends today. So Ibis, as a user, like a data engineer or a data scientist, you write down the expressions specifying the relational operations. And those expressions then get compiled down to either a SQL alchemy expression or a SQL string corresponding to a particular dialect or a flavor for the backend of our choice. Diving a little bit deeper, so Ibis's expression system decouples expressions and the operations. So what that means is that as a user, when you write down your operations like concat or other arithmetic operations, they get type checked and optimized, and a new Ibis expression is built iteratively. Once a user is done writing their expression that they want to execute, then that expression is sent to a backend specific workflow corresponding to a particular backend where it gets rewritten, compiled, and a new SQL string is generated. For example, in the case of a BigQuery, which is supported by Ibis, that is a SQL string generating backend. Similar to the SQL string generating backends, we also have expression generating backend, where instead of generating SQL strings, you are able to use SQL alchemy and as an abstraction layer on top of many databases, and you can output the SQL alchemy strings SQL alchemy expressions instead of SQL strings. DuckDB is the latest supported backend in here, which uses this mechanism. So what does this mean in terms of cost and maintenance of all of these backends in Ibis? So if you were to plot many Ibis backends by the lines of code, what you see is this natural segmentation happen where all the string generating backends are clustered on the left and the SQL alchemy backends are on the right. In the case of DuckDB and Impala, what you see is there's a 20x code of a 20x difference between lines of code, and that is something that is enabled because there were many good choices made by the DuckDB, but also because SQL Alchemy is able to support the Postgres dialect, and we can easily support it in the Ibis world as well. Now, the question for this lightning talk is like, what if we were to support hundreds of databases? This is not so far-fetched because the DB engines today list about 400 databases in their popularity rankings, and these databases tend to be cross-language and multimodal. Enter Substrait. Substrait is a cross-language serialization format for the relational algebra. So the things that can be described in a SQL or like SQL-like DSL. And the way that works is that it has the producers. So Ibis being one of the producers in the Python land, in the R land could be dplyr. In the future, there may be Spark and Presto SQL producers there as well. Those producers basically serialize, they're like logical plans or the relational algebra. And that is sent out to the consumers, which tend to be the compute engines. And in this case, the consumers would then take that Substrait plan, optimize it further, and then execute it at the physical layer. Notice here that Ibis can be thought of both as a producer, where it produces this Substrait that can be handed off to the backend. It can also be thought of as a consumer, where you can write some analytics expression in a completely different DSL, serialized to the Substrait, consume it in Ibis, and then be able to use that expression and extend it with the Ibis's expression system. Substrait's plan has types and expression support, and it also supports a different serializations format. But right now, protobufs is the best supported format, which is cross language. So what's next? How does that help us? So in this Ibis's world, we are actively working on a Substrait producer. That producer is today in our dev version can be run with like DuckDB, where DuckDB is the consumer. And this is an alternate to the SQL string or the SQL Alchemy expression generating a compilation methods. And this also is agnostic to the backends because Substrait being the standard, of all the backend specific logic is like pushed at the database of the compute engine. So enough talk, let's look at some code. So I will stop sharing my screen and share my terminal really quickly and walk you through some of the steps of what these look like. Okay, so I have my IPython terminal already just set up. I have a line item unbound table created for the TPCH to query. So the TPCH schema specifies this. And I also have a Ibis expression, which is a TPCH query expression that is, so we have a TPCH expression here as well, that basically has all the relational operations specified. Okay, so now let's use the DuckDB backend in the Ibis land and try to serialize this into SQL Alchemy expressions and then execute. So our first step here would be to get a Ibis connection. So we already have one here. And now we can actually take this and compile our expression. And what you will get here is a SQL Alchemy object. And this SQL Alchemy object can now be executed against the backend. You can also view this as a SQL string, and like here's the output of the SQL string generated by the SQL Alchemy backend. Now this SQL SQL Alchemy or the SQL string can be executed, and we can try that out by just executing it instead of compiling. So I will do execute, and we will execute this on TPC. Expression, and there you go. So we got the results back here. Now we also talk about Substrait. So let's try to do the same thing. We're like Substrait, where instead of generating SQL Alchemy expressions, we'll actually generate Substrait plan, and that plan gets executed on the DuckDB backend. So let's go ahead and import some of the Ibis Substrait producer and the compiler. Let's build out the compiler. And now let's go ahead and compile our step. So we have the compiler here. Now we can take and create our proto bytes. And let's look at that real quickly. It's gonna be a gnarly long list of things. There you are. So I have the protobytes here already. And now what I want to do is execute them at Ibis backend. So I have an Ibis connection ready to go, and I will execute this from Substrait. So if I have this, I'll do from Substrait, and here you go. We get the results executed back. Notice that we were able to generate or write the expressions without any knowledge of the backend. We just needed an unbound the table schema. And we can do all this stuff separately, serialize into it, and we did not have any knowledge of the backend. We just serialized it into Substrait. And because DuckDB has a Substrait consumer built into their dev version, we are able to execute that. Now, going back to our presentations, I do want to quickly talk about our next steps. Okay, so the key takeaways here is that Ibis is a Substrait producer that decouples the execution engine and the expression building logic. I also have a gist attached by Gil Forsyth, who is one of our Ibis maintainers, who wrote down some of the recent Substrait workflow and its integration with DuckDB. With that, I would like to thank everyone for joining us today. And I appreciate your time.